Hi and welcome to my first video in the series about structures and bonding. Today we're going to be looking at the structure of an atom. So the structure of an atom, you've probably heard the term atom before. And if you broke down any material into its smallest subunit, then an atom would be the smallest divisible unit that you could probably break it into. But there are smaller subdivisions even than an atom, and that's what we're going to discuss today. The three major constituents of an atom are these three parts. You have an electron, and you have a proton and a neutron. And now the protons and neutrons are found within the nucleus of the atom, and this electron appears to whiz round the outside. Now it's got some other information on this slide telling you about each of these subunits. And so a neutron, it has a neutral charge, which means it doesn't have any charge overall. A proton has a positive charge, and an electron a negative charge, and hence why the atom is kept in check. The negative charges that make up the electron are balanced by the positive charges of the proton, and they actually hold the structure of the atom together. In fact, this force holding them together is exceptionally large, and it's the type of force that's utilised in a nuclear bomb. You've also got information about the mass of the different subunits. So, for instance, a neutron has a mass of what we refer to as 1, a proton has a mass of 1 as well, and an electron has a negligible mass, so we refer to it having no mass. And that's summarised here in this table here, telling you the relative masses of each of these particles and the relative charges as well. Now, if I just give you the example of helium, and you've probably seen in the periodic table that you have these two numbers attached to each of the elements found within the periodic table, and they mean something in relation to the amounts of protons, neutrons and electrons. Now, the top number to do with helium, or to do with any element found in the periodic table, that's your mass number. And the mass number is the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. That's the symbol. They normally give a two-letter symbol. In some cases it can be a single letter, or it can be three letters. Most are two letters, and you know it's the same symbol, or the symbol referring to the same element, if it's the lowercase. So HE, and the E is lowercase, that means it's still the same element. And the bottom number, which is the proton number, and this tells us the number of protons, and it also tells us the number of electrons. So in this case, helium, we know, has two protons. It also has two electrons, because remember the proton number is usually the same as the electron number. And this mass number tells us the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. And therefore, that must be 2. The number of neutrons must be 2, because 2 plus 2 gives us the 4 here. So if we look at these as examples and try to figure out how many protons, neutrons and electrons in each, if we take hydrogen first, so H is the symbol for hydrogen. The atomic number, or the proton number down the bottom here, tells us it has 1 proton. This top number tells us the number, or the mass number, tells us the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. So if it's already got 1 proton, that must mean it has no neutrons. And because the proton number is also 1, the number of electrons is also 1. With boron, which is B, the symbol for this, the number of protons is 5, the number of electrons is also 5, and because our mass number is 11, we can tell that the number of neutrons is 6, because 5 plus 6 gives us our 11. Oxygen, that has 8 protons, also has 8 electrons, and therefore it has 8 neutrons, because 8 plus 8 gives us our 16. Sodium, or Na, that has a proton number of 11, so 11 protons, 11 electrons, and therefore 12 neutrons. Chlorine has 17 protons, it also has 17 electrons, and therefore 35 minus 17 gives us 18 neutrons. Uranium, or U in this case, it has 92 protons, 92 electrons, and it has 146 neutrons. Okay, so, but what determines whether something is a hydrogen atom? The determining factor for this is this value here, so the atomic or the proton number. It's the number of protons found within an atom that determines what type it is. So for instance, a hydrogen atom always has 1 proton. A boron atom always has 5 protons. An oxygen always has 8, sodium 11, chlorine 17 and uranium 92. If you look at all of the elements on the periodic table, it's the proton number is the one that determines the type of atom that it is. Okay, so the atoms are made up of protons, neutrons and electrons, and the protons have a positive charge, neutrons have a neutral charge and electrons have a negative charge. The protons and neutrons, they have a mass of 1, and the electrons, because they have a negligible mass, we refer to them as having no mass. Your mass number, how heavy an atom is the number of protons plus the number of neutrons. The atomic, or the proton number as it's sometimes called, is the number of protons, and it also indicates the number of electrons. And there are different types of atom that you can find on the periodic table. You know, there are roughly 120 on the periodic table at the minute, and it's the number of protons that determines the type of atom that it is.